Hey guys, what's up? This is the Flamehead97 here, and welcome back to my channel. I'm here for a top 10 video, and it's been quite a long time since I've last done a top 10 video. So, here in this video, I'm here to list off my top 10 Rihanna songs. Rihanna's been a singer that I've been a fan of since at least the late to mid 2000s, and I'm still a fan of her to this day, but spoiler alert, I'm only a fan of her older stuff. I'm not a fan of like anything past Unapologetically, which was her last good album in my opinion. So with that being said, let's go and get started with the top 10 Rihanna songs. So kicking off my list, and at number 10 is Diamonds, and this is from that album I just mentioned, Unapologetically, which is her 2012 album, and this is one of my favorite songs from the album. Yes, this was a big hit for Rihanna back in the day, and I think it's a good song. So people may not like the song much, but I think it's a really great song. I think it's a beautiful song. It's one of Rihanna's best ballads, and it's easily one of her best songs of all time, so yeah, definitely makes my list. I know it's kind of low in the list, since it's a song of hers that I really do like, but I think Rihanna has better songs, but however, I still think Diamonds is a good song, and it deserves the success that it got. So, yeah, Diamonds from Unapologetically, still a good song though, despite where I put it in the list. So number 9 is Break It Off, featuring Sean Paul from Rihanna's album A Girl Like Me. So yeah, with this song, it's more of like a dancehall song. It's got this really great beat. Rihanna does really great in the hook of the song, and Sean Paul has like some verses and stuff where he raps, because he's pretty much a dancehall rapper slash dancehall singer, so it's pretty cool. So yeah, this was definitely a great song between Rihanna and Sean Paul, and I like the approach that they took with the dancehall, because I like some dancehall songs. So yeah, Break It Off, definitely a great song. Something different for Rihanna, away from her like pop slash traditional R&B stuff, but still definitely an awesome song, so I had to put it on here. I've been a big fan of this song for many years. So number 9 is Break It Off from Rihanna's album A Girl Like Me. So number 8 is Shut Up and Drive from Rihanna's album Good Girl Gone Bad, which is actually my favorite Rihanna album. So yeah, Shut Up and Drive, I really enjoy this one. This is more of like a song that's like more pop oriented. It's got this really great guitar style throughout the song, and it's just awesome. It's definitely an awesome song. This song made me a Rihanna fan back in the day. Well, at least one of those Rihanna songs that made me a fan back in the day, from like one of the Now compilations. It was Now 26. That's how I was pretty much introduced to the song. Well, that's at least how I remember discovering the song, at least for the first several times, you know. But this is a song that's always stuck with me since my childhood days. And I'm still a big fan of Shut Up and Drive to this very day, so I have to put it in my list. So number 8 is Shut Up and Drive from Rihanna's album Good Girl Gone Bad. Definitely a great song. Number 7 is What's My Name featuring Drake. This is from Rihanna's album Loud, which I think Loud was a very good album, but I'm going with What's My Name featuring Drake because, for one, I really like the beat of the song, and two, it's a really good song. And I think Drake's feature on this song was actually pretty good. So yeah, this was like one of several songs that Rihanna and Drake done together, but I think What's My Name is probably their best collab song, in my opinion. So, What's My Name is definitely an amazing song. Really enjoy it. Once again, it's more pop-oriented, but still, definitely a good song. So, I had to put it on here. Great song. So, number 7 is What's My Name featuring Drake for Rihanna's album Loud. Number 6 is Rockstar 101 featuring Slash from Rihanna's 2009 album Rated R. This is back on track for like Rihanna's more R&B type of songs, because she has her pop songs and then she has her R&B songs. So Rockstar 101, definitely a good song, has Slash from Guns N' Roses on the guitar, so that was definitely something cool and creative that Rihanna came up with, including a legend like Slash on one of her songs, so it's definitely awesome. I've been a big fan of Rockstar 101 since like the early 2010s, because that's when I remember first discovering the song, and I'm glad I discovered this song because it's definitely a great song, and I think it deserves to be in a top 10 list when you're mentioning Rihanna, because it's definitely a good song, and I really enjoyed Slash's guitar work on this song, so it's definitely a good thing about the song. So yeah, Rockstar 101 from Rated R, and at number 6 on my list. We're finally in the top 5 now, y'all. So number 5 in my list is You the One from Rihanna's 2011 album Talk That Talk, which I think was a pretty solid album. But I'm going with the opening track of the album, You the One, because I really love this song a lot. It's a really special song to me because I can relate to it in many different ways, you know. So You the One is definitely a great song. Yes, it's a relationship song, but I don't care because I tend to enjoy those songs that are like that, as long as it's not done over and over like one specific artist. But I'm not going to mention that because we're not talking about that artist, we're talking about Rihanna here. So You the One from Talk That Talk, definitely a good song, and it's one of my favorites on that album, so that's why it's the song I went with from that album instead of like one of her other songs. But You the One from Talk That Talk, great song. So number 4 is Unfaithful. This is another song from Rihanna's album A Girl Like Me. So yeah, this is a R&B song. It's got this amazing piano in the song. The original title of the song was Murderer, but it was changed to Unfaithful. So Unfaithful is a really great song. Pretty much a sad song though, because in the song Rihanna's singing about being unfaithful to her significant other. So anyone that's been let down by a significant other can definitely relate to this. Well, not let down by a significant other, because the song is about a woman cheating on her significant other and being unfaithful to her man. That's what the song is actually about, so my mistake on that. So yeah, the song is pretty much about a woman being unfaithful to her boyfriend. So the song that people can relate to, it can even relate to when a guy does it to his girlfriend or whatever, but I'm not going to get into that because it's, that's none of my business if people do that, you know. So Rihanna, Unfaithful, definitely a great song. I really enjoy it, and I can kind of relate to it in some ways because it's a beautiful song, and I've been through a lot of breakups and stuff in my life, so I can pretty much relate to it. So number 4 is Unfaithful from A Girl Like Me. We're finally in the top 3 now. So number 3 on my list is Umbrella featuring Jay-Z. This is another song from Rihanna's album Good Girl Gone Bad. This is the opening track of the album. Of course, this was a big hit back in 2007. And still a song that holds up very well to this very day. It's pretty much another pop slash R&B song. Well, I consider it more of an R&B song than I do a pop song because of the beat. But yeah, definitely a big hit for Rihanna. This was pretty much her breakout song and made her a big star, at least in my opinion, because it was one of her biggest songs to date. So in my opinion, this song put Rihanna on the map and made her a huge star in the music industry, and I think she definitely deserved that because it's a good song and she has other good songs as well. And Jay-Z's feature on the song is just pretty much in the introduction of the song. He doesn't have like a second verse, he only has like the opening track. I mean, the opener of the track, which I think Jay-Z should have at least had a verse throughout the song, but however, it's a good song still. Well, he does have a verse, but it's at the beginning of the song and it's a shorter verse, but what I'm saying is that he should have had another verse in the song, but however, Umbrella, still definitely a late 2000s classic, and one of my all-time favorite Rihanna songs, so comes in at number 3 in my list. Number 2 is SOS, aka SOS Rescue Me. This is another song from Rihanna's album, A Girl Like Me. This is the opening track of the album, and I really enjoy this song. It samples Tainted Love, I think that's the song that sampled, I'm forgetting, but however, SOS is definitely a good song, and I've always enjoyed the song. Yes, it's more of a pop song again, but I don't really care about that, because whatever genre Rihanna wants to do, I respect it, because I like her R&B stuff, and I like her pop stuff, so yeah, no matter the genre Rihanna chooses, I'm a fan of it, because she has a shit tons of good songs. So yeah, number 2, SOS Rescue Me, aka SOS from Rihanna's album, A Girl Like Me. Definitely a good song, and I really like the sample that they done with the song. It's definitely a huge standout. So, this was pretty much another big hit for Rihanna. Made her a star as well, just like Umbrella. So, SOS, and at number 2, great song, one of her best songs. So number 1 is Hate That I Love You featuring Ne-Yo, and this is another song from Rihanna's album Good Girl Gone Bad. I really love this song a lot. It's probably my favorite Rihanna song of all time. That's why I'm choosing it as my number 1 song for this list. So yeah, this is definitely an R&B song. It's got this great beat. The beat is kind of similar to Sexy Love by Ne-Yo, but both great songs, of course, because I know that they were pretty much produced by the same producer, but however, both songs are great. So, Hate That I Love You featuring Ne-Yo has always been a song that I've loved throughout my lifetime. So, yeah, man, Hate That I Love You is definitely one of Rihanna's best songs of all time, so that's why I'm putting it in at number 1. And another reason I'm putting in at number 1 is because it's another song I can relate to, you know. It's definitely amazing. I really love Hate That I Love You. It's great that Rihanna and Ne-Yo have a song together, because they're both singers that I'm a really big fan of. They make great music of their own and together. So Hate That I Love You is another amazing song. I love this song a lot. And I think it's her best song, so that's why I'm putting in at number 1. Sure, she has many other great songs, like I said before, but this song is just special to me. I love this song, great song, and that's all I'm going to say for Hate That I Love You. So number 1, like I said, is Hate That I Love You from her album Good Girl Gone Bad. So I'm going to recap my list for top 10 Rihanna songs. So number 10 is Diamonds from Unapologetically. Number 9 is Break It Off from Girl Like Me. Number 8 is Shut Up and Drive from Good Girl Gone Bad. Number 7 is What's My Name from the album Loud. Number 6 is Rockstar 101 from the album Rated R. Number 5 is You the One from the album Talk That Talk. Number 4 is Unfaithful from the album A Girl Like Me. Number 3 is Umbrella from the album Good Girl Gone Bad. Number 2 is SOS, aka SOS Rescue Me, from the album A Girl Like Me. And then number 1 is Hate That I Love You from the album Good Girl Gone Bad. I know I left out some good songs, but this is only a top 10 video, not like a top 20 or top 15. But if I think of some honorable mentions, then I'll definitely link them in the description of this video once I get it uploaded on the channel. So if you're a fan of Rihanna, let me know some of your favorite songs from her and your favorite album from Rihanna. I'll see y'all next time. Thanks for watching this video for Top 10 Rihanna Songs. I'm the Flamehead97. You guys have an awesome day, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.